Welcome to my channel. Today I would like to discuss something that's been on my mind ever since the Mandalorian Season 2 trailer dropped, which on a side note does look really good. However, I have become quite cynical. The reason for this is because I don't know what they're going to do with Ahsoka. And since Disney has taken over Star Wars, their female characters arguably haven't been very good. And Ahsoka is one of my favourite Star Wars characters of all time, so I don't want them to ruin her. In this video, I'm going to describe Ahsoka's entire story throughout Clone Wars and Rebels and explain why, personally, I believe she should have died during her confrontation with Darth Vader. Back in 2008, Ahsoka was introduced into the Clone Wars movie and was met with lots of criticism, as she was an annoying brat in the movie and the first series of Clone Wars. However, this was overall an intelligent move, as it showed her development throughout the show. She goes from a frustrating little sister to Anakin to a very close friend. Different arcs, like the one where she is kidnapped by the Trandoshans and the one where she is framed for a bombing at the temple, truly represent how good her character is, as she's very strong-minded and determined. She sees the Star Wars world and the Jedi view similarly to the audience, which makes her very likable and relatable. After she leaves the Jedi Order, she is tangled up in Maul's plot by Bo-Katan as she requests Ahsoka's help. In the last arc of Clone Wars, Ahsoka faces against Maul in one of my favourite duels in Star Wars, and the show builds a very interesting connection between the two characters, as Ahsoka's stubborn beliefs end in her refusing to help Maul, who knew about Order 66 and Anakin's fall. Then, we get to see Order 66 from her perspective, and it ends with her faking her death, and making Anakin, who is now Darth Vader, realise that she has died, and that Anakin has truly lost everything. All the Jedi are dead, he has betrayed Obi-Wan, and he has killed his wife, and as a result, his unborn children. The only thing he had left was Ahsoka. But the Clone Wars ends with Ahsoka and Vader both thinking the other is dead, which is utterly genius. After this, Rebels comes around. I have mixed feelings about Rebels, but I will admit that Ahsoka vs. Vader is an amazing sequence. Basically, what happens is Ahsoka has some suspicions that Vader is Anakin, but once she meets him, she swears that Anakin could never be so evil. As the battle between the two heats up, she slices her saber across his mask, breaking it. Then, he says her name, and she is hit by the world-breaking realization that her old master is a Sith Lord. In her seemingly final moments, Ahsoka says that she won't leave him, and he simply responds, "Then you will die." After watching all of Clone Wars, this line is so powerful, as the two characters' bond has evolved so well. It's really emotional and shocking, and a perfect death for a great character. Unfortunately, Rebels introduces time travel. I'm not going to get into why time travel and force healing are both terrible additions to the canon that shatter all tension in future movies, but I will say I hate that Ahsoka is brought back to life, as it makes the final duel meaningless, and in my opinion, leaves her with no story left. Her arc has ended, and it ended when she fought Vader. And I'm scared that she's going to be wasted in Mandalorian Season 2, that she'll just be fan bait, fan service, and they will ruin her. Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, remember to like and subscribe, and please comment what you think about Ahsoka being in Mandalorian Season 2.